Hello again, how are you today? In this little video I will try to explain you the way how you can avail of stinging nettle root in its fresh or dry form, how you can use it in the culinary way, but also how you can make your own medicine, or how you can use it in the medicinal way, culinary way, how to cook with it, or how to make a tincture or just some remedy for any kind of troubles that are in connection with prostate. So if you're suffering from prostatic hypertrophy, or if you have some troubles with prostate enlargements or infections, inflammations of the prostate, or bacterial and fungal infections in regards of prostate, then that's not a shame. It's the issue that any kind of issue that someone might have with with urinary stuff, or with the breathing stuff, or respiratory. It's the part of our body and it's possible to treat it. So what I did is this is what I will try to explain you in this video. I'm cooking soup where I will be implementing these nettle roots that I just pulled yesterday. I was planning to use it yesterday, to cook with it yesterday, but it's okay to use it in any form. Even if it dried, I could still use them dried in the dried form or fresh form. It's still good, you know. So even if you're pulling roots, nettle root should be really dark at the end of the year. So in the fall time, they are really with the highest potency, or very early springtime, or just pull them anytime you need them. You know, when you know that you need them, you want to take them like prevention. When you want to take care of any kind of prostatic issues during the whole year, just dry them and use them as you go anytime. I just wash my hair in the roots of stinging nettles. So what I did is, and you saw it in the previous video, since my hair kept falling, it's pretty much falling after the labor, I've noticed the difference that it keeps falling. I soaked all the roots of stinging nettles in the big pot of cold water. So I made a cold infusion with the nettle roots and tops, big bunch, and I just heated up the following day. So you can leave the roots in the cooking pot or in some pot container thing for the whole 24 hours, or just for half day. Following day you will heat it up and then wash your hair in it. Use it like, you can then first rub it in your, first wash your hair, then, sorry, wash your hair in the nettle root decoction. You can add birch leaves. I added birch leaves and one stem of celandine, grater celandine. But if you have only nettle roots, we will dry your hands, yes, Linda. If you have only nettle roots, just use only nettle roots. If you have just nettle, just a veil of nettle. So I just wash my hair in nettle roots, and then I washed it with the regular water. And then the second wash, I was just rubbing this nettle root decoction in my hair, and I just let it dry as it is. That's very good medicine. So nettle root could be used also topically, as you can see, and also internally for different kind of issues, medical issues, or health issues. Then I made a nettle root tincture. It's probably half jar full of fresh nettle roots and then some fresh tops. So it's very good for any kind of prostate treatment. If you have any kind of issues in regards of the prostate, for prostate cancer as well, but for prostate cancer I would suggest also medicinal mushrooms that are that have activity against prostate cancer. So there are specific medicinal mushrooms that are targeted for the, or they that have activity that are against this prostate cancer, and that's a Trametes versicolor, as probably everyone knows, Turkey tales. Then there is Ganoderma lucidum, or reishi, or just use any kind of reishi you have. Then maitake, shiitake. There is one more, flammulina, I forgot its Latin name, but it's enoki in its cultivated way, or just use, or enoki, or We call it also velvet food or winter mushrooms. I'm sure you know them, orangey kind of mushrooms that are growing mostly in the winter or springtime, early springtime. And you can use all of them for this kind of issue, so not only nettle roots. So as you can see, I made tincture with nettle roots, and I think I explained you earlier in my videos how I made this tincture, but it's based on nettle roots. This tincture will be taken internally every day if you have some acute troubles, or you can use it even topically, and you can keep rubbing this tincture in your hair if you have some issues with a hair fall, with a loss of your hair, you know, if your hair is falling pretty much. By the way, I will have this tincture available if someone would be looking for it. I will have tincture for this prostate issues available, or for a hair loss tincture. So you can just contact me on my email address that I'm leaving under this video. Okay, but this video is really about how I'm using nettle roots. By the way, I'm drinking burdock root tea. So I just pulled some burdock yesterday. I kind of a little bit shredded it, and I was simmering it for 20 minutes, 15 minutes, and that's the way how I'm drinking it. The leaves of the burdock. You can even add the leaves of the burdock. That's a young burdock, really. Nice. As you know, burdock is the part of the anti-cancer Essiac tea. So it's very good and great anti-cancer wild root to be using, and to cook with it, and to make decoctions and tincture and everything. But I will be dealing with it in the different video. Cheers. So it's burdock root tea. Okay, now, so the roots of the nettle. I pulled few roots of the nettle. What I will do now is I have soup on. By the way, I'm cooking wild mushroom soup, which consists of a few morels and black trumpets. It doesn't matter, any kind of wild mushrooms. So it's on for the past 20 minutes with a lots of wild garlic in it and sea salt. What I will do now is, it's probably till this point, I will just chop my nettle roots. Since I know that I will have this soup on for the following 20 minutes and then it's ready, I'm gonna chop roots as they are. Nettle roots, stinging nettle roots. You see, stinging nettle roots, they are kind of yellowish. You can use either fresh roots of the stinging nettles or dried ones. If you have no time to go and dig and find where is some nettle growing, and or if you know that the most potent time of the nettle root is really in the fall time, so just dug a lot of in the fall time and keep them stored in a glass jar or in some cotton bag for the whole time of the year, so you can always pop some nettle root in your soup. I would suggest using the bigger, longer roots and not to chop them finely, because what I do is I pop them in the soup. Now nettle roots are in the soup and it will be simmering. I will let it simmer for the period of 20 minutes. So it will be simmering for 20 minutes, for another 20 minutes. And then I will just take them out. Very easy, I will just pull them out. So you don't have to be afraid that members of your family will find nettle roots in the soup and they will be like, oh, Yoko, what's that? I'm not eating nettle roots. They don't even have to know that it was there. So I will just take it out like this, you see? Just pop nettle roots in your soup, in your wild mushroom or in your veggie or chicken stock, or I don't know what kind of soup you're cooking, or bean soup. I actually like adding them in the bean soup. Pop them in and let it simmer for 20 minutes. Make a light decoction for 20 minutes, okay? So I will put it back on my oven so it will be cooking for 20 minutes. Not boiling, just simmering. Okay, so it's simmering now for 20 minutes. Then I will just take them out. I will just take those roots out, and I will just finish my soup with already ready sunflower seed milk. I have sunflower seed milk here. I just strained from sunflower seeds. This pulp, sunflower seed pulp, is not gonna be wasted because I will be adding it in my flaxseed crackers along with any kind of wild plants, or if there is still wild garlic, I would just add wild garlic in sunflower seed pulp, flax seeds, and that's it. That will be nice, beautiful raw crackers based on the sunflower seeds and wild plants. So I will add, I will switch off, I will take out roots from the soup pot. I will take it out, switch it off, and only then I will pour in this sunflower seed milk, because it's a raw milk and I don't want to destroy benefits. And just some garlic, just some piece of garlic. I have ready here probably 2 garlic cloves, sea salt. I'm using wild garlic salt, and that's it. I have some potatoes in as well, just mushrooms, potatoes, sunflower seed milk, nettle roots that I will take out so nobody knows it was there, so the male members of the family can be happy that you're looking after their health already. You know, they don't know even, and it will be in the soup, and they will be availing, they will be enjoying nice good tasting soup, because it won't leave any traces in your soup. That soup will be delicious. Nobody will know there were nettle roots. And if they knew, it's you know, it's great medicine, how it's the best way, or it's very good way how to avail of this medicine, of these nettle roots, without even knowing, because you can always pop in these nettle roots in your soup. And it's great precautions, I think. And then I will just sprinkle with the wild garlic flowers over the soup, you know, like a garnishing, because I still have wild garlic flowers here already. So as you can see, nettle roots can be used in many ways. You can either cook with it in the soup as I am cooking now, or you can make tincture, or there is another way how you can avail of this root. You can make decocted tincture or double extraction. Double extraction is if you combine the tincture of the roots, stinging nettle roots, with decoction. So let's say I will chop nettle roots, pop them in the saucepan, cover them with the water, just a little bit of water just to cover them. Let's say, I don't know, 1 big jar of water, nettle roots, as much as you have. Let it simmer from the boiling point. You have, it will reach boiling point, switch, reduce it, you know. So it's only simmering, don't let it boil. So when you see the water is starting boiling, reduce it to the simmering point. So it will be simmering. Let it simmer for 20 minutes. And after it was simmering for 20 minutes, switch it off. Then strain it from the roots, keep this liquid, measure this liquid, and then prepare another jar like this one, and get fresh new roots. I would prefer fresh new roots. Someone would use the strained roots from the decoction, but I would use fresh new roots, and I would cover those fresh new roots with 80 to 100 proof alcohol and let it sit in the sun for the next 3 weeks, and then I would move it in the cool place for another 2-3 months, and then I would combine this decoction that you actually have to do on the day when you're combining it. So double extraction of nettle roots is a combination of this tincture with decoction. So if you're making decoction of nettle roots and you have 1, let's say, gallon of nettle root decoction, you need to combine it with 1 gallon of nettle root tincture. But my ratio is always nettle root tincture higher. So let's say I would combine it with 60% of nettle root tincture and 40% of nettle root decoction. Then I combine it. I put it all together. So this is decoction. This is the way how you can avail of the nettle root tincture at the same time with nettle root decoction. So because different benefits might be extracted in the decoction way, and different benefits in the alcohol-based tincture when you're extracting benefit with alcohol. So There is also one literature where they're talking about decocted tincture, nettle root decocted tincture. What they're doing there is they are combining this nettle root tincture is ready. What they do is, what surprised me a little bit is they will combine decoction. Decoction is ready of the nettle roots. They will put it in one ready jar and they will just add alcohol there, same amount of alcohol that you have your decoction. So they combine it together and they just add fresh roots of nettles or even strained roots from nettles that they were decocting in. You know what I mean? So I would better stick to double extraction that is based on alcohol tincture or alcohol-based tincture, and I would combine it with the decoction of nettle roots, but in the proportion where you have nettle root tincture in higher amount. So majority, so 60 or 70 even percent of nettle root tincture would be combined with decoction that is probably just 40%, you know, lower amount. Okay, this is probably boring part, but if someone is interested in the nettle root double extraction, that's the way how you can do it. Again, I have it available if someone would be looking for it. I made some that is sitting for the past already the whole year, so it's very strong and potent. So I have this nettle root available, which is very good for prostate enlargement or prostate infections or bacterial and fungal infections in regards of prostate. Nettle root decoction tincture is to be taken 1 teaspoon daily, and if you have some acute troubles, then 3 teaspoons daily. 1 teaspoon to maintain prostate healthy, really. Ladies, if you're watching this and if you're being kind of worried, why would I be using nettle roots? You know, I will never have prostate troubles or whatever. This nettle root is also great for any for different kind of stuff. It's very good for urinary stuff. I am taking this tincture as well, and it's just beneficial. But there is no harm just to pop in one nettle root in your soup when you're cooking it, and if you have men in your family, it's good. Why not? So it will just add on the healthy note, you know. Okay, so this video was on the nettle root cooking in the culinary way. My soup will be ready very soon. I will just take out the roots and I will just add some flavor seed milk, as I said, and it will be lovely soup. If you like my video, you can just like it or you can share it. I don't mind. You can leave any comment if you wish, or if you're interested in nettle root remedy, you can email me. I'm leaving email under this video. I will definitely reply if I can help you in some way or give you some advice. And that's it for today. So hopefully see you next week. And next week video will be on the different issue or on the different health remedy. It might be on burdock and what we can do with burdock, when to dig it and all that kind of stuff, what kind of medicine you can make with burdock, how you can eat it, because it's all medicinal and edible as well. So I will be probably concentrating on burdock next week. So see you next week and cheers. Bye.